Guys, so let's talk about CPS and the court systems and the authority that they have with our children. So I left a domestic violence relationship. I spent 2 years trying to get out of it, and I had finally gotten away. And a judge 800 miles away signed a restraining order removing my son. Now, with restraining orders, you do not have to prove that they are true before they're acted on. I know that this can end up being somewhat of a problem, but it needs to thoroughly be investigated before any child is removed from a home. This man that has my kid right now never showed any court official nor law enforcement positive identification. That is ball one with law enforcement. Positive identification. Humboldt County Sheriffs did not do that. I mean, it's really scary that I could possibly go into a courthouse, file a restraining order on, say, my best friend, and take his daughter and not prove that she is mine. I just have to prove we had a relationship, which he's my best friend. I lived with him. How does this work? How is this okay? We need to bring awareness to this, guys. We really, really, really do, because I'm still trying to get my son back. This was December that they took him unlawfully. Perjury is only a misdemeanor, even if it gets a child removed. Even if a child is removed from the home, it's a misdemeanor. It should be kidnapping. The restraining order states that my nonverbal autistic 3-year-old is scared of me. Now, he's not. But say he was. I spent every day with him. If my son was scared of me, it should be child abuse that this person was making him be with me. It really should be. It would be child abuse. Making anybody do something that is scary for them is abusive. When it is a nonverbal autistic toddler, it should be prison time. I don't know what else to say, guys. I'm gonna keep making these videos.